Previously on Minute Labs.
This is the Evolution Simulator. There's something else I noticed that I found really amazing. The average age of the blobs in a generation grows to around 2. It does this every time. It looks like there must be some fundamental rule here to be discovered. This explanation deserves its own video, so I'll save it for another time.
Oh, it's you. So you still want to know why the average age of blobs is always 2, huh? You haven't forgotten yet. All right, but just understand, this wasn't easy for me. I thought it would be because I did the math and I thought I understood. But it was the wrong math. Long story short, I figured it out, and there are two ways we can do this. We can do this the easy way or the hard way. You want both? Okay, I guess we do the easy way first. First, let's notice that there's only a certain amount of food placed out each day, and blobs need at least one food to survive to the next day. And days are the same as generations here. That means there can only ever be as many blobs as there are food pellets. We can also assume that, on average, the number of blobs remains constant. This makes sense because if there are ever fewer blobs than there are food pellets, then it's more likely the blobs can find two food and reproduce. Then the population will start growing again and get back to where it should be. So how do we get the average age? If we want to know the average age of the blobs, we count up the number of birthdays every blob has celebrated and divide by the total number of blobs that have ever existed. Every day, the blobs that survived from the previous day get to celebrate their birthday. That's just the average number of blobs minus the average number that die. If we multiply that by the number of days, we get the total number of birthdays celebrated. Every day, we get new blobs being born. So the number of blobs that have ever existed is going to be the number of blobs born each day times the number of days plus the number we start with. Since we're assuming that, on average, the number of blobs remains the same, that means that the number of blobs born is the same as the number that die. Now we can just divide to get the average age. We can simplify this by dividing the top and bottom by the number of blobs and putting it in terms of the fraction of blobs that die. Let's graph this equation and see what it looks like. If 0% of the blobs die, that means that every blob gets one food every day. No blobs die, none are born, and the blobs all grow older together in harmony until the end of time. On the other hand, if half of the blobs die, that means that the other half gets two food and reproduces. Eventually, things level off, and the blobs are, on average, one day old. But in the evolution simulator, neither of these situations really happen. It's usually something in between. There are three main possibilities for a blob. Either a blob gets no food, a blob gets one food, or a blob gets two food and reproduces. So you'd think each of these possibilities is equally likely, and one third of the blobs die, one third scrape by, and the last third reproduce and replenish the population. Turns out, that's pretty much what happens. So let's check the case where one third of the blobs die. Well, an average age of 2. If I were a sane person, I'd stop here. But no, I had to go and check the theory against the experiment. Well, I suppose I don't call this channel Minute Labs for nothing. Let's set up a mini simulation that starts with 1,000 blobs, which are really just numbers representing their age, and every day, let's randomly kill off a fraction of them and replace them with new blobs. Now we can look at how the average age actually changes over time, under ideal conditions, and look at how those ages are distributed. This is really fun because we can see the distribution of age change over time. In the case that no blobs die, you can see that all blobs get older at the same time. But if we add some chance of death, you can see that the initial population of blobs slowly dies off and progressively gets replaced by younger generations until things all balance out and the age distribution stabilizes. The downside of doing an experiment is that it can reveal flaws in your theory. And comparing the average age curves, you can see that they don't exactly match. Sometimes they're actually quite a bit off. So why is this wrong? Well, what we're actually calculating isn't the average age. It's the life expectancy. We can calculate the actual life expectancy of the blobs by looking at the average age of just the dead blobs. The graphs of life expectancy and average age may look different, but they have the same shape and level out to almost the same value. And the graphs on the actual evolution simulator show the same behavior. But why would this be? This confused me for a while. We usually think of life expectancy in humans being around 70 or 80 years, while the average age of humans at any given time is much lower. That makes sense because humans are more likely to die the older they get. But blobs are different. Their age has no impact on their chance of survival. So when the blobs get mixed up and things all balance out, the average age will be the same as life expectancy. But that's only when things balance out. And I want to figure out an equation that matches what we're seeing through all the generations. So we need a different way to look at this. A more accurate approach is to look at the expectation value of age. It's the same thing as the average, but a different way of thinking about it. You can calculate the expectation value of age by multiplying every age times the probability of being that age and adding them all up. The tough part is figuring out what the probability of being a certain age is. Imagine some blob is 8 days old. That means it was born 8 days ago, and it managed to survive 8 days. We already know that the chance of being born is the same as the chance of dying. So what's the chance of surviving 8 days? Well, the chance of surviving 1 day is 1 minus the chance of dying. So if the chance of dying is 1 in 3, the chance of surviving is 2 in 3. The chance of surviving 2 days is 2 out of 3 times 2 out of 3, or 2 out of 3 squared. And for 3 days, it's 2 out of 3 cubed, and so on. So the chance of surviving 8 days is 2 out of 3 to the power of 8. Now we can rewrite the expectation value equation like this. But wait, there's one thing we forgot about. There's another way that a blob could be a certain age. It could be one of the original blobs that were around since the beginning and slowly dying off. They don't have a chance of being born, it's a certainty. They only have a chance of surviving. The chance of an original blob being D days old is just the chance of survival to the power of D. If we run the simulation for 8 days, the only blobs that could be 8 days old will be the original blobs. So we should only add the other age expressions up to the day before. Fortunately, instead of adding up all these values, there's another way of calculating this sum. It's not too pretty to look at, but it works. And after simplifying, we get this scary thing. Let's plot it and hope for the best. I don't know about you, but I think those curves look similar enough. Looks like our theoretical model finally matches our experiment. So, what did we learn from this? Well, hopefully you learned a little bit about statistics and calculating averages. You probably also learned that I spend way too much time solving esoteric riddles, and I learned not to make promises about explaining something before I actually understand it fully. If you want to play around with the plots I showed in this video, there will be a link in the description. In case you didn't know, the idea for the evolution simulator originally came from the Primer YouTube channel, which has a bunch of great videos covering concepts in evolution, and you should definitely check them out. As always, thanks to my GitHub sponsors and patrons, thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon with something new.